Messi. Oh, what a goal that is!
Hi guys, hi, I'm Zul Fadli. You can call me Joe. I'm the team manager of Terengganu FC, and you are listening to the Bola Bola Show.
Hello everyone, this is the Bola Bola Show, and welcome listener. It's me, Elvin, and with me, I have my buddy, Steven. How's it going, man?
Hey, wow, okay. I'm all excited. I'm all excited for tonight's episode, because if you guys can hear the background, we will get into that a little bit shortly. But first thing first, we need to bring in our guest, yes. Zul Fadli Rozi, team manager of Terengganu FC. Welcome to the Bola Bola Show, Joe.
Hi, welcome. Thank you guys for having us.
Yeah,
thank you guys for having me.
We are literally pitchside recording.
Yes, live. Special for Bola Bola Show tonight.
Wow, thank you so much.
Okay. Thank you so much, man. Yeah. Right. So, you know, Joe. So, mm-hmm. you know, I understand your role as a team manager. You know, so as you know, sometimes different country they have some of the coach they call manager. You know, and then the responsibility is all different. So, you know, maybe you for the benefit of our listeners, maybe you can explain what is your role as a team manager, and what areas you get involved in, and what areas belong to the coach.
All right. Okay, guys. I know. To be a team manager in Malaysia, I mean, it's going to be different sometimes. When you're watching EPL, sometimes the team manager will be the coach, right?
Yes.
So, in Malaysia, I mean, I don't... in Terengganu itself, it's like traditionally from years by years, the team manager is like the one who responsible to overlook everything, the team as a whole, other than minus the coaching part lah. I mean, like for me, when I become the team manager for Terengganu, I need to be involved in most of everything related to the team, from the start of the pre-season. I mean, the team setup. I mean, I have to work very close with the head coach, you know, from the to start of the season. Okay, for the start of the season, involved in everything, to set up the team with the players, everything, work closely with the coach, with the scouting teams, everything. And I'm actually represent the Terengganu Football Club Sdn Bhd, on behalf of them to monitor the team. So in terms of not just team itself, other team like you know, traveling, transportations, player welfare. So for me, the role of the manager now is more, you know, closer to the team. Not like, I don't think like before. Before maybe the privatization, you know, the manager maybe sometimes just, you know, the old fashioned way, just go to the game day, show his face, something like that. But not anymore nowadays.
Yeah.
So
we can see you're very involved. You're in the training session today.
Yeah. So I don't know about other team, but for me, this is how we the manager should be. You know, we can't just be on the game day, just you know, when the prize giving day, something like that. You know, when it comes to any official matter, only you just show your face. No, not anymore. When you think about a football club, it has to be changed also. The role of manager has to be changed also. You have to be more involved with the team.
Okay, so that means like all the coaching responsibility, team selection, all that all belong to Coach Nafuzi, and the rest
of the team,
you get involved in the other matters and all that. So
yes.
This, I suppose, involves a lot of a commercial role as well.
Yep. For the team. Like Terengganu itself, you know, we are now getting when we separate from the FA, now we have the first year of the football club, right?
Yes.
So we have a lot of new stuff coming in also. So who looking for the commercial side, who looking for the media side or marketing side, corporate side. So we have a lot of department now here in Terengganu Football Club. So me just more overrun the team to organize the team itself.
Okay, right.
Okay. And as you mentioned, you know, you are also involved part of the preparation, everything. So how has COVID-19, the pandemic lockdown, affected the team's preparation for the 2021 season?
Yeah, actually it affects us a lot, you know. Because to be honest, we have like only 2 weeks official preseason, what we call, right? Because we are only allowed to train on the full scale training only for the 2 weeks. I mean, 14 days, 16 days to be exact, I think. So can you imagine that like a normal preseason should be at least 6 weeks, you know? 6 weeks at least for the normal preseason. Now it cut down to until 2 weeks. So, but I can't say much because it happened to all the teams, so not only Terengganu. So we need to reschedule the training program, right? We need to do some amendment on the training fitness part. I mean, preparation part. We need to do some major amendment on the team preparation itself. Of course, it will affect the team.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Yeah. And what about this year's league? League campaign, you know, Joe. So, what was Terengganu's target for this year?
Yeah, to be honest with you guys,
yes,
actually, when I'm involved with this, actually, this is like the third year me involving in this Terengganu, and when I work with Nafuzi, I think we from the caretaker. Since the Nafuzi as a caretaker and until last season he get the full mandate to run the job as a head coach, we have a long term plan with Coach Nafuzi, to be honest. So at least I would say that to give us like 2, 3, or 5 years to get this team to what we hoping for. So it's quite, you know, when last season full season Nafuzi as a head coach. Not to say we don't expect to do that well, you know, it happened too fast sometimes, you know. Last season we finished third place and then we secured the AFC Cup. It's like, okay, we was planning like, oh, maybe this year or next year we're going to qualify for that. So when you know it goes too early, there come the high expectation from the fan, also the pressure this season, you know, because if you guys know, we have the youngest average squad every single week. If you guys notice that, if not the first or the second youngest average player on the field every single week of the Liga Super League match, you know, so that show how what we want to do. So when people ask me what do you expect to do this season, all I can say, of course, I need to do better than last season. At least better last season. At least still secure the AFC Cup spot, or maybe finishing higher than last season. Maybe a second place for this season. I have to say that because I cannot say that. Because we already finished third last season. We qualified for the AFC Cup. And then how am I supposed to say it? And if I say, okay, I'm going to target for top five finishers this season. Oh. I think all the fans will be mad at us, you know. But we try to be realistic. So that's why I say, all I can see, we try to do better than last season. We try to do better than last season. That's a fair target for us for this season.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
But judging by the trainings, what we're hearing from the background, I suppose the players are very, very enthusiastic to do better than last season. That's for sure.
Yeah. It's all young guys, young player. All they have a very highly, you know, hungry for success. So they are really highly motivated this season. Seriously, they especially the young players.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Mm. And as you mentioned, you know, last season, surprisingly, Terengganu finished third in the group and the reward with the qualification to the AFC Cup group stage. So what is your prospect like, you know, facing clubs from Singapore, Philippines, Myanmar?
Yeah. That's what my part also. When you say you just can't be just a manager, you know. So when you come to AFC Cup, I have to prepare the team for the AFC Cup also. I mean, not in just term of accommodation wise, traveling wise. So about the team that you're going to face in the AFC Cup. So yes, we have a good three contender in the team. Okay, we have like Shan United, Kaya FC Kaya, and then Geylang United, right? Mm-hmm. So yeah, both Shan United and Kaya will play the qualifying first. So they both of the team going to face Australian team, I think. Kaya will face Brisbane Roar, and Shan going to play Melbourne City for the qualifying. And then after that, they fail to qualify. They join our group. So it's good exposure, especially for the young lads to play in the FC Cup, and then with the team like FC Kaya, who we know have a national Philippine player there. Even Shan United also, most of the Myanmar national team player also in the team. And then Geylang also is quite a good team with a few new import signings this season. So it's going to be interesting battle in our group for this AFC Cup.
Mm-hmm. And will this AFC Cup be one of the team's priority for this season or the league? Because you like, what will be the balance? Yeah, be like, because this was something unexpected, yeah. And now you are
yeah. Of course, you want to qualify AFC, you know, but not to say unexpected. If we qualify, then we need to prepare, and we are ready for that. So, you know, Terengganu, the last time we qualified for AFC, you know, when in 2012, you know. So it's been like 9 years already. We didn't compete in AFC Cup. So 9 years is quite long for us, actually. So we are going to take this time seriously. And in 2012, we managed to qualify from the grouping stage. And, you know, we lost to who? If you guys remember. We lost to Kelantan that day. And, in the knockout stage, if you still remember that.
Okay,
that, because that time, you can still qualify and can face the team from your own country, you know, but not this time. I think they're going to avoid that this thing going to happen again. Still remember, we play at noon at time. We play Kelantan. So if you ask me, you expect what we expect to do. So we want to do more than just qualify in the grouping stage. This is our target also for AFC Cup.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Now, in terms of the league, I mean, in the progress so far after 8 matches in the players, I mean, how do you feel so far? What's your feeling?
Okay. I'll be lying to myself if I've not saying that I'm satisfied. But satisfied means not just there. I mean, there's a lot more improvement we need to do, you know. Because if you guys follow our team, we have a quite setback to the start of the league. Yes. We lost 3 players to ACL. Our 3 is like the first 11 player, I can say. The key player, Petrus Itembi, Azali, and the latest one is Rahadi, the young goalkeeper, you know. So, with the losses that we suffer, and then credit to the coach and the coaching staff and all the players do step up. Even though we have lost 3 key players, but with the position we put ourselves now in the third place, right? Still running for the top 2 or top 3 spot. So I'm more than pleased what we have achieved after the 8 games.
Okay. You know, we hear a lot of positive things about Terengganu as a state in terms of how they deal with sports. You know, many people talk about, you know, Terengganu being a sports state. So perhaps you can share a little bit more with us. Uh-huh. When it comes to football in this case, I mean, how is it all about?
Yeah, I don't know. If you're aware, Terengganu is not just a football state. You know, we have I think the only state who have a professional cycling club, right? The TSG itself is doing quite well. And they won last month in Turkey. If you guys noticed that, yeah. And then we have a good hockey team that just won the cup last few weeks. Terengganu hockey team, THT. So that is Terengganu all about. When it comes to sports, not just football, the people here was really, really crazy about sports. So it's not just to say we have a good setup here. Not just football. I mean the what we call that Terengganu Majlis Sukan Negeri Terengganu itself. You know, they have a very good program involving all the sports. You know, that's why since we won the Sukma, starting from there, we keep continue to produce lots of athletes here. So football itself, I think Terengganu can see if you come down here, it's place everywhere, on the street, everything. So not to say that we are Terengganu people born to play football or what, but the passion is there about football here. The passion, was high. It was very, very, very high in terms of football here in Terengganu. Yeah.
We absolutely know this passion, Joe, because we have interviewed Kerte FC.
And
we know these guys have got really big plans and all that.
Yes.
So that's why I wanted to ask you. You know, are there any plans for you guys to have like a holistic approach of trying to integrate all these community leagues? Into Terengganu, like for example, talent scouting and all this, and to absorb these guys into the state team. I mean, the Terengganu team lah. So, are there any discussions in going on?
Yeah, I can
teams
see
like
our
Kerte and Cukai and all that.
Yeah. You know, I think for me, that's the future of Malaysian football. You know, I can say that it's not for me. It's not too much to say that because. Maybe now we can see, but for me, I can see team like Kerte FC, Ray Chuka is the real future of Malaysian football one day. You know, the way they set up the things, everything, and then yes, our management also did have engagement with them. You know, every time we have like a talk about grassroots development, how to set up a football academy. Our office, our chief technical officer always invite the representative from the Kerte FC and the Ria Cuka itself. Not just the two teams, there's a few more teams.
In the
Terengganu
community.
Yeah. So this season, like Ria Cuka who going to compete in M3, Kerte still want to maintain in the M4. So it's a very good scene for Terengganu football itself. Not just Terengganu, but for the whole our Malaysian football culture itself. So you're looking forward to have a good relationship with this kind of this club, you know. So we are welcome more club in Terengganu to do the same as what Kerte and Ria Cuka did.
Okay, wonderful. And you know, on a positive side, Terengganu FC is also being, you know, we hear a lot of positive things about how the management is working within its means, and you know, but how challenging can it be to keep a balance between both on the field, you know, player signing, titles, and the aspiration, off the field, the club finance, and all that. And how challenging it is?
It's quite challenging because when I given the mandate to run this team last season fully, the first thing management asked me is to slash out the budget. It's quite a lot for me, but I cannot say it here, but it's really quite a big budget cut for us. So that's the time me and Coach Nafuzi work it out how to manage the team with the budget that given to us. So that's why we need a lot of young youngsters. You know, there's some other way to keep your tight spending, you know. So the things you need to do to start with the young players. So I'm quite lucky because Coach Nafuzi, the one who are really bold enough to place young player in the squad for Super League matches. if you still remember how he put the young goalkeeper last season in the first Super League match, opening match against Perak. Mm-hmm. And that guy never had experience before, 19 years old at that time, only played for under 19, never played for under 21, never played for the Premier League, suddenly play for the Super League. I think mm-hmm. many people don't know him before. But after the game, you can see what happened to him. Until he got the senior national call up, you know. So I'm quite lucky to have a coach that really, really good enough to use youngsters. So that saved us a lot, you know, actually, if you guys want to know. So beside that also, in terms of challenging that you tell me before, it's like it's good to have that kind of challenge, you know. Maybe before this, you can spend freely to pick star player just to sign for your club, but no more. That kind of challenge, that is what we enjoy enough here in Terengganu. So we take the challenge, and then I think what we spent last season and this season again when we qualified for the AFC, the we also asked to look into our budget again to cut a little bit more, even though we qualified for AFC. But that for us it's okay. For me, as long as the or what we call that the finance situation in Terengganu, for me, if no salary delay, something like that, for me that's better rather than you spend a lot, then you have like lots of problem with salary and other things involving the player.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
Because you know, we always hear these stories about player not getting salary. So it's good that is financially is managed well over there. And like what you say, you know, with a bunch of hungry young players and a hungry coach, you know, mm-hmm, I'm sure mm-hmm. you guys got a good recipe. So what would be Terengganu's targets? I mean, for the next 5 to 10 years, what are the plans?
Okay, you know, guys, I'm maybe I can't say for until 10 years because I don't know how long my stint with Terengganu. Because normally managers come and goes, but now it's like the second year that I can be the team. That's why I say I have like a 2, 3, or 5 years plan for this team. So what I can see in 5 years, you know, we're not just producing young talents. We want to be known as the young producer of the young talents in the country. So when we talk about a football industry, of course, we want to involve in the player trading business also with other things, you know. So we want to produce player not just for us, but for anything that interested with our players. So that's how I'm going to look Terengganu in 5 years time, you know. And then as I said, because we already have a proper plan for this all these youngsters now. I mean, they all signed like long-term contract with us, got 5 years contract, 4 years contract. So this is like a really future team for Terengganu in 5 years. For me, I can see that we going to be a producer of national team squad also. Okay, if you guys remember, we don't have any call up. I think how many years already Terengganu boys don't have a national call up until this season. Okay, even though only 2 or 3 players, but it started to show. It started to have a place in national training squad. So that's why I said in 5 years, that's why I can see Terengganu FC not just competing regularly in the AFC Cup, but consistently in the top 2 or 3 in the Super League Cup, and then keep producing the young local players for the Malaysia football industry. That's what I can see.
Mm-hmm. You know, as a team manager, I mean, what kind of sort of club? I mean, maybe a European club or whatever, whichever club that you always look up to, that you want to model Terengganu FC after, that you always see, this is the kind of team that I want Terengganu FC to be. Is there any particular club you have?
If you ask my coach, of course, he will say Pep Guardiola. If you ask him, definitely he will answer that. Definitely. But you ask me, I'm always a United fan. Sorry, guys. I'm always a United fan.
I am. So.
Yeah, so you know definitely where it comes from. So, not to say because you know not to compare us with the European is like quite a big gap, but the way how you know Sir managed the United team before, how he do with the young generation itself there, who leave a legacy there, so Terengganu capable of doing that also with this generation.
We really look forward to that, man. Yeah.
Terengganu FC, one for the future, man.
Yes, indeed.
Okay.
Yep.
Okay.
All right, yeah. Any last question?
Yeah, Joe. Yeah. I just wanted to check with you. You know, what about things like data analytics and all that? All are you guys currently doing this, like GPS tracking and all for and also maybe for like scouting opponent this kind of thing, you know, like doing this data. Is there a particular department involved in this data?
Since last season, so I introduced the team with the GPS tracker. So we use it for the third year already. So this season, actually, we're going to upgrade with a better system. Okay. And also, as other team also, we use the Instats, subscribe to Instats, something like that. And then the Terengganu Football Club itself already set up a technical site, you know. Not just involving head coach, so a few professor from the Terengganu University involving in the technical part also, the dietitian, okay, the physiology. So we have that kind of team in Terengganu. So we're going to have a meeting. We just had a meeting before Kuala Lumpur game to discuss about this. This is thing I let you guys know because maybe we Terengganu fan didn't also know about this. So we have a technical members now in Terengganu Football Club, not just involving coaching staff but involving two professors from the universities who are in charge in diet food, and then the psychologists also included in the technical.
So it's like a very complete setup. So for the fans out there, it is not just the 11 guys on the field. At the back, there's so many other people working and,
working behind.
Pulling their weight.
It's quite a lot, you know, because we are playing in fasting months. Before the original schedule is only 2 games. Now it's up to 5 games. So it's quite challenging. 5 games in fasting months. You know, it's a tough challenge for us.
Okay. Wow. I mean, not just Terengganu fans. I think any fans who are hearing about what's happening behind Terengganu FC will be really amazed with what you just mentioned, you know, the technical aspect, everything about it. Wow. This is just, I mean, it's such a privilege to listen from you, Joe. Thank you so much, actually.
Pardon my broken English, okay? I try my best.
You spoke very well and, it was a good time, discussing with you here. So, thank you so much, Joe.
Yeah. Thank you. Thank you guys for having us. Really appreciate that.
Okay.
Any
last words from yourself? Any message out there to Terengganu FC fans?
Okay, guys. So actually, we are going to face first time in the season. We're going to play at home with the home fans. So I just want to have a shout out for the Terengganu FC fan. Please come and fill all the 6,000 quota that given to us against Kuala Lumpur. Please make sure all occupied for the 6,006 for this upcoming matches. That's all.
Okay. All right. And any last word from yourself, Joe?
If you saw my tweet, I always put trust the process. I know many other teams also put sometimes love to use the word trust the process, but for me, I really mean it. When we ask the fans or we ask the management itself just to trust the process, what we are going to do here, we are definitely going to do something slowly. I don't know, but surely there we can see the difference. Not maybe in next 2 or 3 years. Mm-hmm. So please, guys, just trust the process.
So in order to trust the process, people need to be patient, right?
Yeah. I know. Overall, you come to the result also. Sometimes you can't avoid fan with the result oriented, something like that. Yeah. But we try our best here to do that.
Yeah, wonderful. And of course, please, Terengganu FC fans out there, please come. Make Terengganu FC home stadium a fortress for the team. Make it easier for your opponents to come to play in Terengganu. All right?
Yeah. Thank you, guys.
Right. Thank you so much, Joe.
All right.
Any last words from you, Alvin? Thank you so much. No, just want to thank Joe, you know, off your very busy schedule, you know, putting us on pitch side, you know, to listen to the players and all that. So really, thanks so much. Yeah.
All right. Yeah. Okay. Thank you, guys. My pleasure.
No problem at all. Okay. That's it.
Okay. All right.
It will end this week's episode of the Bola Bola Show. Goodbye for now.